Well, I just finished listening to the song that you're going to be hearing everywhere for the next 6 months. What's up, everyone? John from Beyond AR TV. It's time for a review of the new Taylor Swift and Zayn song from the upcoming 50 Shades Darker soundtrack. 50 Shades of Grey, the first novel, movie, now 50 Shades Darker. I don't care. I do not care about that. It's glorified pornography. And not that I have a problem with that, it's just that it's available free online, not something with a razor-thin plot made for suburban moms who probably don't want you to see their Google search history. Today, we are talking about the new one from Taylor Swift and Zayn, of course. This new song is actually pretty damn catchy, and I'm enjoying it so far. It's called I Don't Want to Live Forever, and I'm enjoying this nice kind of bubbly synthy production that it's got going in the background, some rumbling bass and some hi-hat hits here and there. It's a well-produced and sleek song that I think has a lot of flair that is going to attract people to it. Now, I, you know, contrary to popular belief, did not hate Love Me Like You Do by Ellie Goulding, which I believe was the official theme for the last 50 Shades of Grey movie, and now this one, of course, has even bigger names that are drawing people in. The Weeknd also did a song, Earned It, that I could not stand, really, honestly, one of his worst songs for that soundtrack. I'm a Weeknd fan, but I was not a fan of that song. So it's exciting to see them getting two people that I thought had, you know, enjoyable past releases. Zayn's got a really, really good voice. While I didn't really connect with his album Mind of Mine all that much, there were great songs on there that I really did love, like Rear View and Pillow Talk, of course, the number one single. And I feel like this one is headed for number one as well. Taylor Swift, a huge draw, obviously, and Zayn Malik, formerly of One Direction, just two massive forces in the music industry. And you put them together on not a fantastic song, but everything that I feel like I could have hoped for in this collaboration. It actually has a strong hook on it. I think both of them are solid vocalists, and I like when they actually come together, Zayn on the first verse, Taylor on the second, and obviously talking about all of the pain of losing a potential lover, or did I just, you know, make a mistake or something like that. I enjoy the reflection on this track. It's nothing too heady that you're gonna have to like ponder and decipher the lyrics, but it's not something that you should. It's a pop song. It's made for this soundtrack. It's made to be commercially consumed. And for that, I say it is fine. Honestly, I think this is one of the better pop songs I have heard in recent times. And trust me, I just came out of doing the worst songs of 2016. I know bad pop songs. Yeah, I like that it's not just a cop-out like drop or something on the hook. They actually have a chorus where they're singing, and I enjoy it for the most part. I think that most people are gonna like it as well. I'm a sucker for the synthesizer, and they do a pretty good job in adding this ambient atmosphere and tone to it. So I'm gonna have to say, I'm gonna give this a strong 3.5 out of 5, maybe even a light 4 at some point, but I doubt it. I'm just gonna say 3.5 for me personally. What are you guys thinking? If you have not heard it yet, there's a link to stream it on Apple Music in the description down below. I'll update it if they put it on YouTube or Spotify or anything like that, although Taylor Swift and Spotify, not exactly BFFs, so I kinda doubt it. So anyways, leave your thoughts in the comments section down below, guys. Be sure to smash the like button on this review here today. I do hope you enjoyed it. If there's other songs that I've missed, maybe you want to see me talk about or anything else on the channel, let me know. And I will see you guys very soon right here on Beyond AR TV.